Lives is more than just a hashtag for a West Omaha family.
Tonight, they're telling their story of a September day that almost turned to tragedy. Through the rolling hills of Walnut Grove Park, painted grass marks a path.
It's boring just to sit around all day.
So 7th grader Memphis Zabawa runs.
Yes, Memphis!
He has his reasons for taking up cross country.
To build up my stamina and endurance, basically for soccer.
But at a meet on September 8th, that stamina was fading. This picture taken at the start of the race. The air quality that week in the unhealthy zone, especially for a 12-year-old with asthma.
You know, he's running slow. His feet look pretty heavy.
The Millard North Middle Schooler doesn't remember much.
Starting and then getting like over there to the trees behind you and then getting back there, and that's all I really remember.
Memphis and his two friends had come around the corner, and I looked at them thinking, Memphis isn't okay.
Julianne Gray didn't know the Zabawa family.
Right about the kind of third tree in that row is where he went down.
Then all of a sudden his coach came running by me. And so when that happened, that's when I knew something was wrong.
Memphis collapsed. It was an asthma attack.
We rolled Memphis back over from his side to his back, and he had started to turn blue and his lips were purple.
We got up there and yeah, he was on the ground, pale, bleeding on. And yeah, they started CPR on him. And
I never thought that I would be in a situation where I would have to do CPR or go through those measures with a 12-year-old.
It was hard to believe that it was real, I think. You see him laying there, eyes were as wide open as could be.
Memphis's mom says it was like a simulation, that everything worked the way it was supposed to. Well, there's one more thing that was working in Memphis's favor. The ambulance was just a few hundred yards away at a Millard South football game.
Erin Zabawa was at the hospital by the time her son arrived.
I saw a lot of nurses, a lot of doctors. I saw a lot of tubes.
Memphis was intubated for 16 hours. It was a nightmare of the unknown, of what's next, of if there is a next, the official diagnosis.
Severe asthma attack, which led to cardiac arrest.
But Memphis woke up. He was saved by strangers, a couple teachers, another parent, a coach, a team of EMTs and doctors.
Honestly, it's a miracle that he's here and that he's okay. Yeah, I think we're all kind of shocked.
Memphis, the miracle. Already catching up, competing again, and not scared to run back out there.
Not really.
Why not? Why'd you want to just get back out there?
Because I felt like I was going too slow.
It's full speed ahead for a 12-year-old with dreams.
Yes!
Yeah, be in the World Cup.
And a family whose cup is full again.
The fact that there was people there, people who accepted right away, you know, that's, I guess, a miracle right there.
We are forever grateful for them.
The family wanted me to emphasize the importance of knowing CPR and how to use AEDs. And whether you're officially certified or not, if something's wrong, don't wait around for somebody else to take action. Those precious moments are likely what saved Memphis from permanent damage or worse.